What's going on, everyone? Austin John Please here, and today we're going to be taking a look at a leak back in February that leads us to believe that the open world of Pokemon Legends Arceus is actually going to be a lot more open than we were first led to believe. When I went over my 35 things you missed in Pokemon Legends Arceus, I did say specifically about these cliffs over here. When I said that, there were a few people who actually refer me back to one of the original leaks. Earlier this year, February 26th, we had a Pokemon Presents, but a few hours before that Pokemon Presents actually came out, this tweet came out. February 26th at 6:38 a.m. my time, meanwhile this Presents was 9 a.m. my time. 10 a.m. my time. So this came out like 3.5 hours before the Pokemon Presents. And I remember seeing this tweet right here, and I was like, no, I don't believe it. It looks too good. Why would Pokemon do something like this? They're announcing two games, and I immediately dismissed it. Putting my foot in my mouth after that sentence. But yeah, this tweet came out talking about this, but there was also a series of screenshots. This one talking about that there's going to be Pokemon Brilliant Diamond Shining Pearl. This one talking about Legends Arceus. This one about fighting Pokemon in the overworld with this Rhydon, this Lucario, what appears to be a small Shinx. Whatever this is, we still have no idea what this could be. Now that everything else in this picture is accurate as far as like the health meter, how it looks down here, that's actually very close to how it looks to the final image. This down here, this is maybe what it looks like when you have more than three Pokemon, because we have only seen if you have three Pokemon in the party. We saw that you're able to shift around with your Pokeball over here by hitting the X button, or maybe you have to hold it, we don't know yet. And in this screenshot here, we saw that if you have three Pokemon, you're going to cycle through them. In this image, we're led to believe that if you have more than three, you're going to be able to cycle and they're all going to appear here on screen. Maybe that changed, we don't know. The user interface is going to change a lot, especially from February to now, right? What the heck is this? I still have no idea what this is or what this could be, but we do know that there are these Pokemon that have the Fury icon and that have, you know, what appears to be the same health bar. So maybe they changed the health bar UI, or maybe this is some sort of a mini boss that we don't know about, or a specific mission. Yeah, with these eyes and these eyebrows and almost like this Lionel weapon over here. No idea what this is, but we do know that Pokemon attack you in the overworld and in the wild. So this makes more sense now. Still have no idea what this Pokemon is. But the thing I kind of wanted to focus on here was this image right here. So we do have confirmation that in the wild, you are going to be able to, you know, move and then roll forward, right? In this image here, you're hiding in the grass, and maybe these are the Chimecho or something. Chimecho, I don't know their name. And you're going to be able to just throw Pokeballs in the wild like that, right? When it comes to the riding abilities, this Pokemon was blacked out. But now we have confirmation that this is Werder, or Weirdier. I'm never going to stop laughing when I say that Pokemon's name. This boy over here, the antlers are pretty much exactly the same as in this image right here. Granted, it's blacked out, far away, and panned, so pretty much from what we can see the same. The third image is clearly Hisuian Braviary with the little triangle thing that you're going to be riding on. This guy over here, the little triangle thing at the bottom that you're going to be able to hang on to. And oh, it's not just hanging, but there's like a little place that you can lie down. I see that now. But in the middle is this. There's a few things that are weird here. One, in this image, you can see the player, only the Pokemon is blacked out. Again, only the Pokemon is blacked out. Actually, the saddle is blacked out as well, right? So you're only seeing the trainer model. In this, however, everything is blacked out. Why is it completely blacked out? When looking at the legs of this model, they're far too skinny to actually be the legs of the trainer. Also, it seems like this is a very slender figure. Now, if we look, you have one leg here. You have one leg here going to the torso. I don't know what this little bit is. It possibly looks like a tail. I don't know what this giant helmet, it's a huge looking head. Huge looking head, big leaf coming out of it, and very, very bulky forearms, right? And this enormous backpack. And the only thing that really makes sense to me is this long leaf on its head and this very like rounded face reminds me a lot of the rounded face of Nuzleaf and the leaf on its head. It's not uncommon for us to have a split evolution when a new line comes out, and instead of going to Shiftry, which becomes more like a tree and has this long flowing hair, instead, if it's a regional Nuzleaf or a Hisuian Nuzleaf or a split evolution of a whole new Pokemon in total that has more slender arms, and Nuzleaf is known for climbing trees. Maybe the Hisuian Nuzleaf, or the split evolution, is known for climbing mountains. That could make sense. And Nuzleaf is also based off of a Tengu, a Japanese yokai with a long nose who uses their supernatural powers to protect forests and play cruel tricks on people. What if this Pokemon is known for being, you know, the protector of mountains? Big question mark there. And I'm starting to think that this is just a large backpack that you can ride in and the player is just not seen, or maybe this Pokemon is significantly larger than we're set to believe. Like, look how large Werder is and how huge Hisuian Bravery is. What if this Pokemon is so large, really like tall Titan Golem sized, that you're just chilling in here? Like, in here, sitting, you know, crisscross applesauce, and that's how you go up the mountain. And then once you're at the top of the mountain, the Pokemon ride goes away. Maybe, maybe not. But with this being accurate, these two being accurate, that being accurate, we know what this Pokemon is now, we know what this Pokemon is now. It's fair to assume that this is going to be a real thing. Plus, this is a leak from February that only now just got confirmed. Again, what the heck is that, man? What the heck is that? What's this duck-looking boy? These three images are confirmed. What the heck is that? Actually, there's this thing in the top right. Do we have that zoomed in? Yes, we do. This thing in the top right, can I possibly translate this? I can translate it. According to this image, it translates to Battle of the Kings. So, as I originally thought, this is going to be some sort of a boss fight or something, or one of these fury-looking Pokemon, but that Battle of the Kings makes sense. Makes sense. There's also image 8 out of 15 or something. There were more images. This account has not posted any similar images or any leaked images pertaining to this whatsoever, so no idea about it. I'm just excited because, as I was talking about in my video, there's this huge world. And if we look at the map, which is actually just my desktop image, there's a lot of mountains everywhere. And looking at this overpass here, it looks pretty much impossible to go over. As well as here, I mean, maybe this is a pathway, but still, being able to climb over would make a lot of sense. Just climb over the mountain in the same way that we had, what, rock climb before in the original Sinnoh games? Look at this entire region. How are you gonna traverse this, man? How are you gonna go over that? There's still so much we don't know about this. Oh yeah, there's also Basque Legion, and we didn't see that in that leaked image, but that's fine. This might be a completely scrapped concept, but considering how many mountains there are and the validity of everything else in this image, I'm led to believe that this is accurate. And you know me, I don't cover leaks for no reason. I'm not one of these guys that's like, oh, someone on 4chan wrote something. This looks legit. I'm just getting more and more excited for Pokemon Legends Arceus. If you are as well, be sure to hit the thumbs up button down below and look at the subscribe button, because chances are YouTube may have unsubscribed you, or if you want to be subscribed, you may have thought you were subscribed if you watched my videos before, but you aren't. So consider hitting that subscribe button. Until next time, Austin John out.